I'm going to give you a recap of the 2950 Intergalactic Aerospace Expo for Drake, and we're starting right now.
Hello and welcome aboard your Drake interplanetary craft. Your systems are online.
Thank you so much to all the support from patrons, channel members, and Twitch subscribers that make this possible. Welcome to A Star Citizen's Guide to the Galaxy. Today I'll be giving you guys my thoughts on all of the Drake ships currently on display at the 2950 IAE Expo. This was recorded from my live stream earlier today with some fast forwarding to shorten its length. This is completely unscripted, so take my hard facts with a grain of salt. If you'd like to see my thoughts on the other manufacturers, check out this playlist in the info card above. I've done enough talking, let's get to it.
All right, I'm gonna be your tour guide today. Looks like Drake doesn't have any other hull, so we're just gonna be using the top center and bottom. Head over to the first ship. First ship is the Tick, also known as the Drake Herald, the worst ship in the game. It's also the fastest ship in the game, but it's only fast in one direction. It's a data running ship. It's really cool. Man, look at those little tiny missiles in there. That's terrible. It's also one of the only ships that I know that you actually get into it from the starboard side. The entry door is on this side, where most ships are on the port side entrance. But it does look kind of cool. It's just it flies so terrible. It's got physical data systems that you can pull out, I guess, and like move around. So when I first saw this, it opened my eyes to maybe that the data running gameplay is more complicated than I thought. I just figured that you could, wirelessly send data within a certain amount of range, and then you'll take it somewhere and wirelessly send it to some other place. Anyway, these panels here actually fold out and turn this whole thing into a big like satellite dish. So that's pretty cool. It's got these little stubby wings with little stubby weapons. And then back here, you can see that this thing is really just a engine and thrusters with a cockpit attached to it. Cool ship with its idea, but it's just kind of useless today and flies like poop. All right, let's head over to the next ship. The next ship is the Buck. It's the glass cannon, if there ever was a glass cannon. I love disabling these in the verse with my sucker punches. We got size 4 Revenant Ballistic Gatling up top. This thing's got a lot of firepower. Size 3 under here, I believe. We've got missiles. Some more like size 1s or size 2s, some smaller weapons. Again, engine and thrusters with a cockpit attached. I think you guys are probably getting the theme here with Drake. But a lot of DPS. Cool ship. It's just I'm not really in for the... Like, this would be a better ship if you had a crew. A whole fleet, you know? And then you could just come in and just buzz by, cause some sort of a disturbance and a distraction, and then get out of there. It's also a very fast ship. Very fast ship. All right, let's go over next to the Cuddy Blue. Cuddy Blue is the Mando's Razor Crest in Star Citizen. I hope they get like a silver skin for this. That would be so dope. It's got the Judge Dredd helmet right there for the cockpit view. It's got some DR model XJ3s, which I actually recommend keeping those now because those weapons are pretty good right now for deleting shields. It's got some Mantises up top and a turret. So it's basically the same as the Cuddy Black. But if we hop into the back side of it here, we'll see. You got a little bit of room for cargo here. I believe 12 SCU, if I'm not mistaken. But then you've got these like cryopods that you can put your warm bounties in and make them cold. There's 12 of them total. Of course, this gameplay isn't functional yet, so these don't do anything. But this is pretty cool. You got weapon storage there, but it's actually locked. Right? Because you don't want these people to, get out and take your weapons and use them against you. So, and the rest of it is the same as the Cuddy Black. Still has the turret. Let's go ahead and take a look at the next variant. The next variant is the Cuddy Red. The Cuddy Red. No, I'm sorry. It's the black. I'm sorry. This is the base model black. The same as the blue, except it doesn't have a quantum enforcement drive. This can actually stop people and NPCs from quantuming away. This doesn't have the capability. It's got the same firepower capabilities. And if we head to the back, we can see that it has a larger cargo hold. So it's all cargo hold rather than having those cryopods. Good ship, good multi-crew ship, a good post-starter ship, if you want to call it that. All right, now to the Cuddy Red. This is probably one of the most useful ones. Now, what this has, or doesn't have, I should say, is it doesn't have a manned turret up top. It's got this little, like, scanning dish. So it's got some decreased firepower, right? The pilot DPS is still the same, so that's fine. It also has distortion cannons under there, which is pretty good. And it looks like, yeah, so same. Oh, no, it's got Panthers up top rather than the Mantises from the blue. So, again, we got a little bit of cargo hold space, like 12 SCU. I believe you can get a rock in here, but it's, like, really tight from what people have told me. I haven't tried it myself. But what's cool about this one is if you take a look at the beds here, you can actually set these as your ICU. So if we go around, get close enough to this, it's kind of finicky sometimes. You can also do it from this over here, I believe. Oh, well, maybe I can't do it because this is a display unit. Anyway, you can walk over to this and set this as your ICU, and if you die, then you will spawn back here. So makes sense that they actually would turn that off. But you have to be within a certain range. And again, this is all the same, except we get a space shitter here. Yeah. Oh, wow. So you just shit down the shower drain? Okay, anyway. So pretty much the same here, except for just that one part since there's no turret. I wish they can add a toilet to the rest of the variants, to be honest. We got another couple beds, I guess, for the doctors to sleep there. So, or the nurses or the frontline workers. All right, this, ladies and gentlemen, its reputation precedes itself. This is the Drake Caterpillar. Currently has the largest cargo capacity of any ship that we have in the game. Great for taking a ton of cargo from planet side up to space stations or maybe to other planets. Fun fact, this pod here that you pilot this from is actually detachable. It will be detachable at some point. It's not yet, of course. And these pilots are actually known to race these. Hey, is this a new skin? I've never noticed any gold. What is this? This isn't the pirate edition, I don't think. Go around to the other side. Tons of cargo space here. Unfortunately, you can't drive land vehicles in. That's a huge thing for me. Like, I wish that this would fold down and then an elevator would pull it down and then I could put a land vehicle on it, pull the elevator up, and then store land vehicles in. But right now, that's not possible. It may never be possible. Same thing here in the front. Even if it was just the front. Even if just the front one did that. That would be really cool. It's going to have a tractor beam. That's a tractor beam station up there. Really cool ship. I'm sure most of you guys are fully educated on the Caterpillar. So let's go ahead and head downstairs. Now we've got the Dragonfly. One of my least favorite things because I hate trying to get these things in the back of other things. But this is a bike. What's cool about it is it's got a second seat back there and that person actually faces backwards. So that's pretty cool. It's just a little speeder bike that you can fly around. It's got some scatter guns on it. Nice. And I'm surprised they don't have the yellow variant here, the yellow jacket, or I forget exactly what it's called. There's another color that they don't have. Maybe they have it on the other side. Nope. Just a sitting area. All right, let's take a look at the hollow hall. Ooh, yes. We got the fan favorite, the Drake fan favorite Corsair, which is basically like Akani, but made by Corsair. Also, kind of reminds me of like a similar role that the Mercury Star Runner might have. Of course, it doesn't transport data. I'm sure it's going to have an okay amount of cargo space, probably comparable to the MSR. I'm not really sure, but it's got a lot of firepower. Look at that! Look at that! Look at that turret fire or that pilot firepower. Look at the you got turrets on that side. What are these? Those are more guns on the wings. I love asymmetrical designs. Really do. And another turret on that side. A lot of firepower. A lot of firepower. I expect it to be fragile. Now, does that mean... Oh, look at all those missiles. Jeez. Wait, is that another gun up there? Or is that a sensor? That looks like a sensor. Oh, and a turret at the back. Dope. It's got everything really covered except for the bottom. That'll be its weak spot. So cool. Yeah, by fragile, I hope it means that it's actually like less fragile or more fragile than the Connie, but the Connie needs to get a buff. But we'll see. Hopefully it's not like the Connie. This is the Vulture. I get the V ships mixed up. Yeah, Vulture. This is the Vulture. This is a salvaging ship. Really cool ship. Can't wait till this gameplay gets to come in. But it's basically like what the prospector is for mining. This is the prospector for salvaging. Really cool ship. One important thing to know is that if you buy this ship from the pledge store for less than what a prospector costs, you'll actually get a prospector as a loaner. So we'll talk about that more when we go over the pledge store. But yeah, that's a cool ship. So that's the Hollowview area. Oh, well, no, we got one more ship. Got the Kraken, baby. Got the Kraken. Hold on, let me. Look at that. Man, I can't wait for this. This is gonna be so cool, man. You just come up to like roll up on a bunch of people, and then everybody just starts scrambling for their. I would put arrows on there. I would line this thing up with a bunch of arrows. I put them all like I guess I'd put them all like on these top top decks, the top deck here, just line that up with a bunch of arrows. And then maybe put some other Drake ships on the bigger pads. Because the arrows, you can fit so many arrows in a tight spot with those wings folded up. Can't wait for this to be in the game. It's going to take more people to crew than what we currently can fit in the server, but... Supposed to be the privateer version, I guess. Huh? Oh, look at that. Oh, that's dope. I like that. This thing's probably going to be fast, huh? Loads of Merlins. Nice. Dude, this has a lot more detail than most ships. A lot more detail. Like, this thing looks like it could be damn near flight ready. All right, flyable now. We got the buck. 110 for the buck. I don't know about that. I can't do that. I can disable that ship so easily with sucker punches. Cuddy Black. Great ship. Cuddy Blue. It's $175. A whole $75 for a quantum enforcement. And you can't even put people in the back of that bitch yet. The Cuddy Red. They should make all these ships comparable to like what you could do with them today. And then when they put in the feature, then up the price. Yeah. 135 for the red, that's not bad. I'm probably going to upgrade. That's probably going to be one of the upgrades I'm going to do today. Upgrading to Cuddy Red. Of course, the Caterpillar, great ship. I don't like the Dragonfly and the Herald. Fuck the Herald. Did that go up? Was that? I thought that was $75. Maybe it was always $85. The Vulture is a good one to buy. Let me show you why. The Vulture gets a Prospector and a Buccaneer as a loaner. A prospector and a buccaneer. We're gonna go over this again because I need to record it for actually I guess I can just no I'll just use this recording. Yeah. The Vulture is why am I recording on fuck I'm not supposed to be recording. Buck is just engines with a cockpit. Yeah, but this is a good deal, boys. If you own a prospector, you can melt it, get this. You have a prospector until salvaging is in. And when salvaging comes in, I guarantee you it's going to be the best way to make money because they're going to want to promote people to use this. So this is really cool. And the Corsair, that's a pretty good price. I'm not really that much of a Drake fan, but I would say that this is probably the coolest ship they have, for sure. Oh, shit. So if you buy, like, so here's the thing. The Kraken's not there, but you could just spend $4,200 and get the whole complete pack, and I'm sure it has the Kraken in it. So that's pretty cool there. Already sold out. Kraken Warpond sold out. Nice. And the other one sold out too. They're both sold out. Kraken's gonna be a cool ship. I wonder how far along they are on the development of that. The Kraken Privateer. I don't know the differences between those. Chat, let me know if you know. What's the difference between the Privateer and the base? Kraken Aftermarket Kit. What the fuck is that? I'm sorry. I haven't made it to this level of whale yet, so I don't know much about that. Now, these are pretty cool. $14 for two cat skins, or of course like $7 a piece. Wait a minute, what? Oh, these some of them. How are they gonna charge more because of the color? Damn, dude, they know how to get us. Cause now I'm like, well, fuck it. If I'm gonna spend $11, I might as well spend $14 and get two. You know, Privateer has shops while the base has none. Okay, but what does the base have in place of those shops? That's the question. And then let's see. There should be some Drake merchandise. Yeah, you can get that. That's actually a pretty cool shirt. I would wear that. The mug is pretty cool. I'm not a big fan of these, of a mouse pad with a picture on it that you're just going to cover up. You won't even ever see the Cutty Blue because your keyboard is going to cover it up. Oh, schematic poster. Oh, that's cool. All right. That is it for the pledge store, ladies and gentlemen.
If you enjoy my channel, there are so many ways to support it. I go live on Twitch just before almost every YouTube release, and I'd love to see you there. There's also free options like Prime Gaming subscriptions and sending off a UEC in the verse because reviewing ships is expensive. There are also sub club subscriptions, merch, and more generous forms of support. Head over to subliminalschannel.tv to learn how. Your support in all forms makes this channel possible. Even your viewership, liking, and subscribing goes a long way. To continue watching, here's a video I think you may like. Here's a video YouTube thinks you may like. And until next time, citizens, I'll see you in the verse.